Splash, Simba, Hydrox, and Boo, the Lucky Ferals.
It's 9 a.m., and I just found another ant situation today, so I don't know if you could see this. So this is the corner of the door that was caulked up, but now they're coming from here, so they found a new entryway in, and there's a whole big trail of ants. So now I have to follow this trail and figure out where they're going and why they're going there. There's a whole trail. This is where they're going, look. This is the crunchy puzzle for the cats, and there's crunchies in it. And I put it aside the other day because the cats weren't playing with it that much, and look at this, the ants found it. So I have to put this outside right now. It's 4:47 p.m. right now. Simba's hanging out in the round tub. It's 8:36 p.m. and I just walked past the living room and I saw this. I actually saw something different than this, but close enough. So there's the cardboard cat scratcher, and I put it on the cat wheel today because when I was cleaning up from the ants, I needed to get everything up off the floor because I was vacuuming everything and cleaning everything. And so I put the cat scratcher there. And Splash, who we see here, walked up to the cat scratcher and he was gonna scratch on it, so he put his paws on it and the wheel started moving. And that's when he jumped off of the scratcher and he's just sitting next to it right now. So it's gonna be very interesting to see what happens with the scratcher on the wheel. I haven't given up on this wheel yet. I still think someday the cats are going to use it. It's about 6 p.m. right now, and the cats are all waking up from their nap. And today, I went to Michael's, and I bought the last Pom Pom Garland that they had in the store. And it was 40% off. So I got an even better deal on it than the last one. And this one I'm going to keep in one piece. I'm not going to cut it into separate pom-poms, even though Simba loves the separate pom-poms. But they'll have this one to play with, just like this. And I also found out something else today. So it used to be that when you went to Michael's, you could use competitors' coupons. So if you had a coupon for Joann's or AC Moore or something like that, you could use it at Michael's. So you'd always get like a really great deal at Michael's. And now, since this COVID stuff, they don't take competitors' coupons anymore. So that was a little bit disappointing, but I guess I understand that because their business has definitely been negatively affected by everything that's going on. So if you shop at Michael's, just know that you can't use competitors' coupons there anymore. Boo, you want the pom-poms? You want the pom-poms? Oh, Stella wants them. Stella says she wants the pom-poms. Don't forget, Stella loves snakes. These are pretty heavy as a garland. You gotta be kind of careful with them. I didn't take the tags off yet. And that cat grass has seen better days. It's been well loved by the cats. I even watered it the other day. I think it's just past the point of no return. Oh, sorry. Sorry, Stella. Simba, you got all the pom-poms. Simba, you got all the pom-poms. Boo says, how come Simba gets all the pom-poms? Because you get the dragonflies, Boo. Simba's wearing it like a vest. He's gonna lay down in his pom-poms. He's purring. Right now it's about 9 p.m. and I have 4 hungry cats here. And about an hour ago, I cooked up some fish. So this is some cod that was cooked and it was cooled and it was shredded like this. And I gave a little piece to Stella, she didn't want it. I gave a little piece to Simba, he didn't want it. But I'm curious to see, like, if I give them some of this with their meal, if they'd eat it. This is what the cats are getting for dinner. So they're getting some Earthborn Holistic Harbor Harvest. They're getting some of this cod and they're getting a few crunchies on top. So there's their food. Splash should eat it because he's had this food before. Unless the cod scares him. Okay, so we'll check back with the cats in a few minutes and we'll see what they've left on their plates. Are they gonna leave all the cod on their plates? Or are they gonna try it? Okay, the cats finished their food and look what happened. Look at this, look! They ate the fish. They ate the fish. I don't know who ate it, but they ate it. It's 9:45 p.m. and Hydrox is at the back door, so I'm gonna give him a can of food, right, Boo? Hydrox is very hungry tonight. He's eating an entire 6-ounce can of Trader Joe's ocean fish cat food. And maybe because I haven't seen him, like I didn't see him for breakfast today. I don't know if he came by for dinner yesterday. He hasn't been around a lot lately. I don't know where he's been, but he's really hungry now, so I'm happy that I looked out the back door and I saw him there. It's 10:30 p.m. Simba got all the pom-poms. Simba! Simba got all the pom-poms. Simba, you look so pretty in your pom-poms. He loves his pom-poms. Simba, you love your pom-poms? Okay, yeah. You love your pom-poms. The cats are having a midnight snack. They're getting their crunchies. Be nice, everybody. Good morning. It is 8:23 a.m. And last night, Stella was laying next to the grass, exactly where she is right now. And when I went to bed last night, she was sleeping next to the grass, exactly where she is right now. And I just woke up today, and she's still there. She loves this grass. And look, I mean, it's a mess right now. But when I grew the cats, the large bed of cat grass, which I haven't done in a very long time, they used to like laying in it even after it was pretty much dead. So I think she still enjoys the grass. Pooh is very nice to Simba right now, and he's done that to him quite a bit lately. I've probably seen that 3 or 4 times over the past week, where Boo will greet Simba, you know, with a kiss, and he'll, to me, it looks like he might start grooming him, which I think would be amazing. If Boo started grooming Simba, like, that would just be such a huge progress for Boo. And Simba would let it. I mean, if you saw what just happened, Simba, you know, did not flinch. He was just kind of waiting for Boo to groom him. And Boo gets so close to doing that. There's Boo now. The crunchy plates are still there from last night. Oh, Boo must have found a crunchy. And Simba loves his pom-poms. It is 9:33 a.m. And I was just on the other side of the house and I heard a meow. I said, oh my gosh, that's Hydrox. And I opened the back door. Here he is. He wants food. And look what's going on here. There's Ditto and he's drinking rainwater out of that water dispenser. And I have it over there because I was going to get rid of it because all summer long it's just been full of algae. But maybe he likes it. Maybe I should actually put some water in it. I have not fed the inside cats yet. I've gotten nothing done this morning except talk on the phone. It's been one of those mornings where you just get distracted. And now I am going to feed Hydrox, put some food outside for Ditto, and then feed the inside cats and actually do the whole cat chore thing. So I've been wondering why this mat keeps moving. We just saw why. So Hydrox has been using this to scratch on. And this is what happens, like every day I notice the mat has been moved like this and every day I have to push it back. And I've also been wondering why, like, this mat is such a mess. I don't know if you could see, because there's a lot of reflections, like all the loose fiber on it. That's because Hydrox has been pulling it out. Good morning, Ditto. Would you like some food also? That's some homemade raw food for you with some water mixed in and some herbs. Eat it. I just moved Ditto's plate over and I took a quick look in this water dispenser and it's just full of like dirt and stuff, so he's drinking dirty water. Okay, I just cleaned out this water dispenser and put a whole bunch of fresh water in it. It's 9:45 p.m. This is what's going on. Stella, Splash, and Simba, they gather around the cat grass. Right now, Splash is gonna go investigate. He hears something. Oh no, he's just gonna move there. This is what Boo has done to his newest dragonfly toy. So he pulled all the wings off of it. I would say it lasted a few days, maybe it lasted a week the most. Then he kind of loses interest after the wings are gone. So there's another dragonfly without wings on the floor. So what happens now is when I give the cats a little bit of catnip, they pretty much just lick it up. They don't go crazy over it. So what I realized today is that I should go back to the pet store where I bought this cat grass insert and I should buy another one. So that way, like right now, I can be growing a new one as they still have this one with, you know, the grass that has seen better days. And then when the new one is grown, I could put it and the turbo scratcher, and then this one I can empty out and get set up with growing new cat grass, or, you know, wait a few days and then get it set up. So there would always be like one container of cat grass in the turbo scratcher, and then there'd be another one being prepared while this one was in here. So I'm thinking that's what I might do over the next few days. Go see if they had another one. Stella loves her boa. She's been walking around with it for like the past half hour. The same way Boo loves his cape, that's how Stella loves her boa. She's laying on the pom-poms. There's two raccoons in the yard. You probably can't see them because I could hardly see them. I have a flashlight on them. It looks like one of them's been just like pooping in the yard. I can't tell. I can't tell if the raccoon's like pooping or peeing or what. Okay, now the two of them are walking off. They're walking off, but there's two raccoons, but they've just been like chattering at each other. I don't know what's going on. Thank you for watching this Lucky Pearls video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you'd like me to post more videos, and please make sure to check out these other videos that were selected especially for you.